quite a different sort of person than they used to be during the 1920s, during the Al Capone days.
Johnny, you got to be fucking kidding me with the cameras here. Look at this over my head. I got a fucking boom mic over my head.
That's right.
I go into cars and shut doors and put fucking cones over my head so people can't hear me. And you got a boom right over my head.
Today they try to put on more respectability.
There's Gandolfini and The Sopranos and Paulie Walnuts and them. Those are the new guys. And they're the ones making all the money. And it's the biggest scam in the world.
Yeah, but they're the guys that got nothing to lose.
And we don't either now, because it's a new world. There ain't no more machine guns. Now it's computers.
They're bigger thieves than us in Hollywood. Well,
absolutely. These are the thieves. These guys with all these microphones and everything? This is the new equipment. This is the hustle.
That's my dad. He worked for Al Capone. What Bugsy Siegel saw in the deserts of Las Vegas, my dad saw in the cornfields of Iowa. I bet you didn't know the mob was in Iowa. Between my dad and my Uncle Frankie, there wasn't too many people we couldn't get next to. But the cornfields weren't for me, so I took my family and their story, and I moved my hustle to Beverly Hills. That's Sonny and Johnny. They're like family. My name is Johnny Lou Fratto, and I'm a son of a gun.
Well, being the son of a famous gangster, you know, people seem to treat you a little differently. But I like it.
Hey Dad, these are our new producers. I'm gonna get my crew.
All right.
Great to meet you all.
Whoa, looks just like that guy Bob.
What the fuck happened to Bobby? I don't like this. The last I saw, Bob went for a ride to the gas station with Johnny.
In reality, I'm just a little misunderstood.
Johnny, have you ever heard anybody before?
Say that again. I probably hurt some people's feelings a lot, I think.
But they all had it coming.
They did have it coming.
You never heard anybody's feelings that didn't have it coming.
There's always accidents.
The flu?
People get the flu, yeah. They fall down.
Choke on a chicken bone.
Accidents do happen.
It's amazing.
It's a sad thing.
Are you insane with this fucking thing?
This is, I'm telling you, trust me with this. Have I been wrong? You never seen me be wrong.
Trust me, that's Italian for fuck you.
It is, but not this time.
That's why people get nervous around me.
Bob, what's the matter with you? Get out of the car. Come on. What is the problem? You fucking nuts, get out of the fucking car.
Okay. I'm going.
You shouldn't yell at me. I'm very sensitive.
The truth is, I'm just a simple guy trying to make an honest living.
Let me tell you something. I got everything all worked out for Paris Hilton and Kim Stewart to ride these bikes at the Maxim Hot 100 party tonight.
Ride the bikes?
You know what I'm saying.
Hold on. Those are prototypes. We just spent $2 million retooling the factory. I don't want anything happen on those bikes, man.
Nothing can go wrong. So
this is your ticket to Hollywood? A half a chopper?
It's small. It's just small. That's all. That's perfect. This is it. The girl's on the red carpet tonight. Maxim magazine. We're famous.
Sonny, you look like Marlon Brando on there.
So when it came to girls, size matters.
We gotta know about this thing.
Right here, you got your gas tank cocked. You got your battery on switch. This is your choke, flip it forward. Whatever you do tonight, when the girls are out on the carpet showing these things off, don't touch this button.
Johnny, do not touch that button. Make sure. Nobody.
You know what I'm saying.
Yeah. This peck cock here, watch out with that too. I don't know what that means.
That turns the fuel on for you.
It's a very unusual word for that.
The one thing that's most important to me, the well-being of my kids.
What are you doing? You're still here?
I'm gonna get you a fucking shot.
You're watching Goodfellas with a baby? Come on.
You're supposed to get that thing. I'm gonna go do that right now.
Do it. Let me watch him. Hey, Joe.
Look at this, Joe. Just like all of our guys.
I don't know. Maybe some of my old man rubbed off on me.
Get down.
Streets were killers of walk like Pistol Pete and Pappy Mason. Gave a
the young boys' admiration. Prince from Queens and Fritz from Harlem, street legends. The drugs kept the hood from starving. Pushing cars, Nicky Barnes was the 70s. There's a long list of high-profile celebrities. Worldwide on the thorough side of things. Life is king,
we're gonna go nuts. Joey, Grandma. Present for you. Do you want it? You want Daddy to show you what it is? What's this? Gus.
Okay.
Wow. Be my kid. Say thank you.
That's cool.
You know, when you have a life like mine, you do what everybody else in Hollywood does. You turn it into a reality series.
Come on, we gotta be across town in 20 minutes. This pitch.
Across town, I put my pants on right when they get here.
2 seconds, John. We go to them. They don't come to us.
Please, I need you to get dressed. Can you put on some pants? I said casual, not pantsless.
All right, Sonny's gotta go.
Sonny can't.
Sonny goes everywhere.
Out of the question. Please, Johnny. Sonny scares people.
By the way, did you meet Sonny?
Tall and tight and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking.
I've dealt with a lot of crazy shit in my life, but nothing like this.
Yeah, Johnny, we know your story, and we like it. But we're thinking of going a different way.
Okay.
We like Wally for the part. We have a holding deal with Wally. You've seen Wally on Larry Sanders. He was terrific.
Maybe I'm a little slow. You want him? You want Wally to play Johnny?
Yes, we do.
In a reality show.
Why can't I just play myself?
You're perfect to play yourself in real life. But in reality, it's a different thing.
They'll let Wally into their homes.
And they won't let me into their homes?
Well, they don't know you yet.
I can understand that they don't want Sonny in their homes.
A little scary.
But me, I should be let into their home. I just don't think he could be me. I just don't see it. I can't see it.
It's a natural reaction.
Tell me this is a fucking joke. Are you fucking kidding? Are they kidding me? What's that fucking look?
Guy's gonna end up in the trunk.
They're looking at a reflection of each other.
Hey, fucking low.
It's gonna grow on him.
You're gonna be me. You're gonna be me.
Sir, I don't think there's any way you can be me.
Really, I don't think I can be me. I'll save it for later.
No, you gotta smoke. You wanna be me? You gotta fucking smoke.
You gotta fucking smoke.
Oh, you can't do that no more.
I can't do that.
Don't do that.
You're gonna very upset me now if you do that anymore.
I don't wanna
very
upset you.
He's upset. What the?
So now I'm ready to put my hustle on Hollywood.
Go to my right, go to my right.
There you go.
Right there.
Oh my God, that is fantastic.
Hey, everybody, you guys see me on TV? Watch. I see you. Yeah. John? What's the matter? John? John?
Tommy, your brother's been in Hollywood way too long.
Now tell me something I don't know.
The Meow Mix guy?
I love this guy.
I'm Johnny Lou Fratto.
What?
What's my name?
Johnny Lou Fratto.
What's my name?
My name is...
I'm Johnny Lou Fratto, and I'm a son of a gun.
Wherever you go, in any town you go to, the big rap star goes in, the biggest athlete in town goes to that same party, and the biggest drug dealer goes to that party. And it's always been the case. Always.
They follow Reverend Run. They have a file on Run DMC. So they follow the Reverend, and some gangster from Hollis, who they still know, visits them. The gangster leaves, and they continue to follow the Reverend.